A fifth Dubai Dewhurst in 7 years for trainer Jim Bolger, but also for son-in-law and jockey Kevin Manning, who joins me now, having won on Dawn Approach, who, Kevin, really is just quite a special talent to our eye. Just give us an indication of what he is to ride.
Yeah, well, he's very, very straightforward. He's very, you can drop me and you can really do anything you like, and he's got a great cruising gear, picks up, just ticks all the boxes.
Because thus far, his father, New Approach, is probably just about the best horse you've ever ridden. But this horse seems like dad without the attitude.
Yeah, he's much easier to deal with than the father. Father used to get pony to the start, and there was always a little, temperament about him, whereas this lad is much, much, much more straightforward.
And six runs as a juvenile takes a bit of doing, particularly when he started, would you believe it, in the first two-year-old race of the whole season in Ireland.
Yeah, it's been a long year, but he's kept progressing, and he's strengthening up all the time, and he's improving, I think, all the time.
I know Jim wanted to get him out a couple of times and couldn't for various reasons. How important do you think that mid-season break was for him in terms of his development?
Yeah, well, I'm sure, from Ascot, he had a busy campaign up to Ascot, and it was a nice break for him to get from Ascot. And, and he'd done very well at the Curragh in the National Stakes, I know, after a long layoff, but I think it stood him in good stead.
And he won so many Dewhursts, and oftentimes they're not the most straightforward two-year-old races to ride in because the pace can sometimes be muddling. Is that why Lettermore was running today, even though he's run a tremendous race in second?
Yeah, well, you can often just find, a small field of runners, and we found over the past that things don't always unfold the way you like them to, and you only get one chance at those big races, so it's nice to have a horse there that can cut out the pace and make sure it's a true run race.
The time was encouraging too, just a tick quicker than the older horses in the Challenge Stakes at the beginning of the card. How did the pace unfold through the race?
Yeah, I felt we popped off and we went a very, very good pace. It never dropped, and the lead horse kept quickening it all the way down the hill and into the dip. And when I took it off from the dip, I went all the way to the line. I think it was a true run race,
And as regards the horse's future, clearly the targets present themselves next year. Given the dam side of his pedigree, do you think he's a horse that can go further than a mile and into that Derby realm that his father did?
It's very hard to say from at this stage to say 7 to 1.5 miles, but I've no doubts that he'll get further than a mile.
But just because he's so relaxed.
No, I mean, at the line he's 7 today and running up the hill. He's showing no signs of stopping. He's going all the way to the line. He's a horse that I think he'll get a mile plus in the future.
In terms of all the Dewhurst winners you've ridden, Kevin, which has given you the most sparkling feel on the day, on Dewhurst Day?
I don't know. It's very unfair. I'm just very happy to have ridden all five of them. I'd rather not compare them.
How much of a kick does it give you to ride the son of a horse that you were associated with so inextricably?
Yeah, well, to ride any horse with the ability he has is very exciting. But it is great to have ridden the father and to be riding one now as good as he is.
And to be part of the dynasty.
Part of the whole thing, yeah. It's great. It's fantastic.